Okay, we are learning Daf Nun in Sukkah. We are beginning on the bottom of Mem Tes Amud Beis. The two dots there says Kamaseh B'chol, just like it was done during the week. You did the same process on Shabbos, except for on Erev Shabbos, they would go get the water and they would put it in a kli. The Mishnah said that was not Mekudesh. Okay, it was in a Mekudesh. It was not Mekudesh. In a golden barrel, actually, it says. It was in a golden barrel that was not Mekudeshas from the Shiloh, and they leave it there in the Lishka over Shabbos. So the Gemara assumed the reason why it needs to be in a, Okay. The reason why it needs to be in a kli that's not Mekudesh is for one of two reasons, or maybe both. Number one, Rashi says that Havamina is that a kli, if it would be Mekudesh, if it would be a kli shars, that means it's a kli that's used in the base of Mekudesh. So once you put the water in, then even if you're not planning on using it right away, it would become Mekudesh. And the halacha is the things that are Mekudesh can't stay overnight. There's a psalina. Things that stay overnight become pasul. So maybe that's why it had to be in Mekudeshus. And number two, because if it would be Mekudesh, the assumption here is, well, let's say I have less water than necessary for the avodah, for the Nisach Mayim. Would that become Mekudeshus? You know, maybe not. And if I have more water, also maybe not. Maybe it's only if you have the exact amount of water that you need, so then it's like designated for the mitzvah, and therefore become Mekudesh, and therefore become Pasul Balina. And therefore they used a chavis, which was large, and they had way more water than was necessary. Right? So that's why the Gemara is assuming that even if so the Gemara is assuming A, it had a chavis, and it was the Ein Mekudeshes to make sure it doesn't become Kaddish. Because it's concerned that if it's going to have the right amount, or it's going to be in a Kli Mekudesh, even if your plan is not to use it right away, it's going to be become possible Lina. So the Gemara says, really? Va'amai. Nice to be Mekudeshes. Let's use a Kli that's a Kli Sharis. Why can't you? So Gemara says, Amar Ziri Kasavar Ein Shiur Lamayim. The reason why we can't use a kli that is Mekudesh is because A, even if it's not the right amount, it'll still become Kaddish. And number two, even if you're not planning it, even if it's Shlemi Das, that means even if my intent is that the kli should not be Mekadesh until tomorrow, is irrelevant. And even if you don't have in mind for it to become Mekudesh, it will. And that's why you can't use a kli that's Mekudesh, because otherwise you'd have a problem. And if you would use a kli that's mekudesh, if silu b'luhubalina, then the water would become pasul because it stayed over the night. Again, they're drawing the water on Friday, and therefore, if it's going to become mekudesh, it'll become pasul b'lina, which means water that spends the night out of the ground, and the kli sharis becomes pasul b'lina, just like any almost everything in the base of mekudesh. Like a carbon, if it has an expiration date. It depends what kind of carbon it is, but there's a psalina, and then it becomes no good. So the water also, that's why we said that, remember, the water in the kiyar, that the big cistern, that a big kiyar where the kahanim would wash their hands from. So someone made a pulley system that you were able to put it was a pulley that actually went down into the water overnight, so all the water in it wouldn't become possibleina, because they had a lot of water in it. So things that send it over the night become possibleina. Now the Gemara says, well, maybe not. Maybe even if it would be, well, Chizki Amar, Kli Sharis Ein Mekachin El Mikdas. The emes is, really, you could use a Kli that's Mekudeshes. Because Kli Sharis is only Mekadesh if that's your intent. But if you drew the water and says, you know what, I don't want this to become Kaddish until tomorrow, then it wouldn't be. So then why'd I have to draw it on Erev Shabbos? Gezeira Shema Yemru Ladas Niskachu. The concern is that people that are going to see the water, they're going to see you using water that hung out on the base of Megdash the whole night, they'll say, oh, I guess there's no psalina when it comes to Nesachim. And the Aslam and Echorva, people are going to think the wrong halacha. I'm not exactly sure what the Chorva is, because the people who let them think what they want to think, you know, they're not the ones involved in the process. So I'm not exactly sure what the issue here is, but the concern is that people are going to think that there's no psalina when it comes to the Nesachim, the things that are poured on the Mizbeach. And my Kasha just says, I'm not sure, you know, why that's such a concern. Okay, next. And even if you would say that you need a shear for mayim to become pasul, that means the water only becomes pasul if it's the exact amount that is necessary, which here would be shleishes lugin. But if it's more than that, then it would not become kaddish. Aye, so why were they using a chavis, a big barrel, and drawing more water than necessary? Says the Gemara. Still, there's a gezeira. The concern is that when you have that much water, they're going to think that it was actually drawn to wash your hands and feet with, because there's a lot of water, and that was your intent, and therefore when they see that all that water, they're going to assume that that's what it was drawn for, and there's no psalina for the water that was drawn for that, and therefore it would be a problem. Okay. They want to say that if it spills, then b'dieved you can just take water from the kiyar. It didn't have to actually come from the shiloach, the amai. So it says, what was, remember what the problem was? If it were two issues, either if the water spilled or it was left uncovered. So it was like, what's the issue if it's left uncovered? The concern is that we said maybe a snake drained from it or something like that. And then it's, Rashi said it's missing a shear. So, because So the Gemara says, well, it's very easy to find out if a snake drank from it, because if it drank from it, it released its venom into the water. So then, misanenis, yeshbay, I'm sorry, I skipped the line, liaver bimisanenis, just pass it through a sifter or a filter. Filter the water, and then you'll see if there's anything in it that shouldn't be there. And then you'll know if it's not the right amount or whatnot. So says the Gemara, oh, must be that our Mishnah is not like Reb Nechemiah, because we have machloikis in the Mishnah. The tiny misanenas yesh Reb Shem Gilei, Amar Reb Nechemiah, ema zev izmancha hatachtena megula, av izmancha hatachtena mechusa, av apisha aliena megula, em bay mishum gilei, mibnei sha'aras nachash dema lesveig safa ein bimakaymai. So there's a machloikis here between Reb Nechemiah and Rabbi Emachacham. If you put water through a strainer, through a filter, is there still going to be an issue of gilui? The Chacham said, yes, there is. Rabbi Nechemiah says, no, because the case is referring to the bottom and the top one. The top one is uncovered. The bottom one is meaning the bottom of the strainer. So anything that came through, you can tell whether there was something in it or not. Anything, if there was a ras, if there was any venom, so that would be, it's like a sponge and it would stay afloat on top. So you'd see it there. The Chacham said, not like that. So the Chayyur of our mission says that there's a problem of gilui, and we're not going to allow you to to put it through a filter. It must be that our mission is not like Reb Nechemiah. So the Gemara says, I feel the same Reb Nechemiah. Reb Nechemiah, our mission could go like that too. But there's a different issue here. Emer dam Reb Nechemiah lehedjit. When does Reb Nechemiah say you can use a misanenes? That's if it's giving you to drink. You want to drink the water. Avol gavoya, but you want to use it in the base of Midosh. Avol gavoya miyamar. But lastly, does Reb Nechemiah not agree to the concept brought in the Pasuk? The Pasuk says, Hakiriveyu na lefachasecha. Would you bring this? The Pasuk there is talking about a animal that's lame or sick. So the Pasuk says, Hakiriveyu na lefachasecha. Would you bring this to a officer, to the governor, to the president? Hayitzarcha, would that be desirable? Or would that show favor? So this is not something that's it's mavuzah. If an animal drank from it, you don't bring that as a carbon. So that's irrelevant of whether there's now poison in it or that's missing a share. That's not the issue. The issue is that something that is mius, something that somebody drank from, an animal drank from, you don't use as a carbon. Now what's interesting is actually machlekes. If this is a pasuk in Nach, so what status does that have? Is that deraisa? Is that the rabbanon? The pashas is, it can't be deraisa because it's not in the Torah. So it's a svara. Sorry. So it's a divrei neviim, which is stronger than the rabbanan. Okay. Others say that it's the pasuk is just saying a svara. See, svara, something that's a svara, you use a svara for. So that has the din of a deraisa. You ever see? We come across a gemara. The gemara sometimes says lamalikra svaru. Why do I need a pasuk? It's logical. Terry expects you to use your brain. So this is a svara. How you cover it? Would you bring, if something you that is not fit to brought to bring to an official? So for sure you can't use in the base of Mikdash. So therefore it would be a psalm of the rice and not a psalm of the rabbana. The shayla is b'diavad if it's what happens b'diavad if you use something like this, would it be kasher? So the Mishnah Berurah, the Bir Halacha says that how could it not be? And if it's what happens if a person brings a carbon that's a chayla. You know, it was a skinny, a nebuchadnezzar animal. Of course, it's going to be kosher. You would say the svara. Should you bring something like that? Of course not. But if you did, I can't say that it's going to be possible. Okay. Hadron alach lulav harava. Hadron alach lulav harava. Hadron chalon lulav harava. Be'ezus Hashem will be back to you. Lulav and harava. And now we continue with hachaliel. Hachaliel chamisha. The shisha. Chalil is a flute. And the chalil was for 5 or 6 days. And what is this chalil? Zeu achalil shal beis hasheyeva. This is the chalil of the beis hasheyeva. She'ein adaycha. It doesn't push off layas of Shabbos, but layas of Yom Tov. That's where it's either going to be 5 or 6 days. If Shabbos is going to be if the first day of Yom Tov is Shabbos, so then you'll get 6 days of Chol HaMoed. So you'll be able to have you'll have it for 6 days. If Shabbos Yom Tov are different days, so you're not doing a Shabbos Yom Tov for the Simchas Beis HaShoeva. Now, what is this Beis HaShoeva? Rashi says the Beis HaShoeva. Where does this language of Beis HaShoeva come from? So the third line down in the Rashi's on the Mishnah, Kol Simchazu Eina Ela B'Shul Nisach Hamayim. The Simcha comes because of the Nisach Hamayim. Kedemafarish Ushaftemayim B'Sasay. She'iva Shoev means to draw. So they would draw the water. Therefore, the simcha was called after the drawing of the water. So it has to do with the simcha's beis hashoeva, has to do with the nisach hamayim. Okay, that's a Rashi, but we'll see on the Amud Beis. Tosfos has a different shot. So that's the simcha of the beis hashoeva. Now, Tosfos, look at the bottom Tosfos there. It's like, what do you mean it's not Deich HaShavos? What exactly should, like, what issue is here? What issue, what issue are we dealing with in the Simchas Beis HaShoeva? What did they do at the Simchas Beis HaShoeva? They played instruments. There was music. That's the Chalil. They were playing instruments. So is that Asur Medaraisa? What is there in playing instruments on Shabbos or Yom Tov? Okay, they're in the Beis HaMikdash. What's the issue? So Taisa says, Apagav the Chalil ene Asur Ela Mishum Shemi Yitaken Klishir. The reason why you're not allowed to play instruments is because there's a concern maybe you'll fix it. Right, which has happened, anybody who plays guitar, right? If the string snaps and you put in a new one, right, that'd be a deraisa because you'd be mitaken mana. Could be even tuning, I don't know. Maybe tuning the guitar could also be an issue. So the issue is that maybe you're gonna fix it. That's the issue deraisa. So playing music is a gazero, that maybe you'll fix it. Rashi Tosfos brings an example. Kamoi le misafkin v'le mitafkin, the clapping or dancing or banging. Is asr because maybe you'll come to fix it, a instrument. The kaimel and shvus b'mikdash, and we know the halacha is that we don't have the rabbanan shvus in the base of mikdash. So what's the issue here? So Tosfos says base of shvu'eva shani, keda amrina begemara de ena ela mishum simcha yisera. This is interesting. Tosfos is extending really, meaning this wasn't an avoda. This wasn't a necessary thing to do in the base of mikdash. You didn't have to do this. So you're right. For things that were necessary, so that would be Dechish, Shabbos, and Yantiv. But things that were just for Simcha Yisera, for extra pump. So then, L'chaira, that wouldn't be Decha. This could be Shayz L'Shitas, as we'll see in a minute. But, okay, that's what Tosfos says. Let's go right there. Zach Te'el Gemara, Dav Menomid Beis, Itzmar, Rav Yehuda, Rav Eino, Chad Toni She'eva, V'chad Toni Chashuva. One says the word is called, it's called the Simchas Beis HaShoeva, like we're familiar with. The other one says that it's actually Simchas Beis Chashuva. It's choshev. It's important. Amar Zuch Amanda Tani She'eva Le'Mishtabesh. The one who says She'eva, he's not making a mistake. Umanda Tani Chashuva Le'Mishtabesh. Meaning these are both plausible gear size versions. Manda Tani She'eva, where is he coming from? Le'Mishtabesh. The pasuk says Ushafta Mayim Besasin. So it comes from the language of Ushafta Mayim, of drawing water. Umanda Tani Chashuva Le'Mishtabesh. One who says that it's really Chashuva is the Amar of Nachman, Mitzvah Chashuvahi. Uba, this is Uba Mishesh Mebreshis. This is a very important mitzvah that comes all the way from Mishesh Mebreshis. Remember, because the Shisin that the Nesachim went down were already created from Mishesh Mebreshis. So this is a mitzvah chashuva that come that's been in the planning forever. Okay. Now, if you look at the top Tesis, Tesis gives another reason from the Yishalmi why it's called Beis HaShoeva. Not because they would draw water, but Yishalmi Farsh, Shemisham. Shayavim Ruach HaKodesh. You were able to draw divine inspiration at this party. Shashchina Sheira Mitech Simcha. Because the Shechina dwells with Simcha. Dechsev Vayi Kenagin HaMenagin Vayi Tihi Olav Ruach Hashem. When the Menagin would start playing his instruments, then the Ruach of Hashem would rest upon, I think that was Shaul or David. Umayisi Uvda, the Yonah Ben Amitah. The Ben Yushan brings the story of Yonah. Remember Yonah from the whale, Yonah ben Amittai, Shehayim Eiler Regalim. He went to be Eiler Regal, who be Simchas Beis HaShoeva Shar Slav Shchina, and he got the Nevuah at the Simchas Beis HaShoeva. That's where the language Shoeva comes to draw. It wasn't because they were drawing water, but because they were drawing Ruach HaKodesh. And okay, for Shimon, it's possible that the Machleik is here between Rashi and Tosfos. Tosfos is saying that the Simchas Beis HaShoeva is because you're drawing Ruach HaKodesh, not because you're drawing the water. And Nafkamina is the Simcha that we're doing because of Nisuch HaMayim? Meaning, is it part of the halachas of Nisuch HaMayim? Or is it part of the halachas of Simchas Yom Tov? These festivities that they made in the Beis HaMikdash, the Chalil, the flute, all the party, the big party that they made in the Beis HaMikdash, was that because of the Nisuch HaMayim? It was in preparation as part of drawing the water, that it was the pump that went along with the drawing of the water. That's what Rashi is learning. Or is it the din in Simchas Yom Tov? Sukkot is a time of Simchas, is a Samachta B'Chagacha, a special time of Simchas Yom Tov, and that's why it was a Simchas Beis HaShoeva. Is it a din in Simchas Yom Tov? Or is it a din in Nisuch HaMayim? Is it part parcel of the avoid of the Beis HaMikdash? Or is it a din in Simchas Yom Tov? The Rav Kamina would be nowadays. Is there an din to make a Simchas Beis HaShoeva? Is if it's a din in Simchas Yom Tov, so let's make a now one too. If it has to do with the Simchas Beis HaShoeva, with the Nisuch HaMayim, so I don't know. Okay. So I think I'm right. Turn up on it. HaChalil Deiches HaShabbos. The Chalil, the flute, is Deiches HaShabbos. Divrei Rabbi Yosi Rabbi Yehuda. Chachamim Aymim Av Yom Tov Ein Deiches. Not only is the Chalil not Deiches HaShabbos, it's not Deiches Yom Tov. Now, which Chalil are we talking about? Are we talking about the Chalil of the Simchas Beis HaShoeva? Or are we talking about the instruments that they played every day in the Beis HaMikdash for the Shir Shel Yayin? What do you mean? Okay, could be. Maybe, or maybe both. I'm just pointing out that the instruments are used at different avodas. It was used every single day during the Shir, when they sang the Shir Shel Yayin. So they did that with musical instruments. And by the Simchas Beis HaShoeva, they had musical instruments. So what are we talking about over here? Are we only talking about one? Are we talking about both? So Rabbi Yosef weighs in on this, and he says, "I'm Rabbi Yosef. Machloikis b'shir shel carbon. Their machloikis is only regarding the shear of the carbon that was brought every day, the shir shel yayin. The Rabbi Yosef savar ikar shira b'kli. Shira needs a kli, needs instruments." Okay, Rashi says that now the shir was of course the tehillim that was said, that was what was sung, but shir for it to be shir needs musical instruments, not enough to sing it on your own. The avodi, and therefore it's part of the avoda, but the chesed Shabbos, and therefore it could push off Shabbos. Rabbanan savri ikar shira bepeh, singing is done with the ikar shira is bepeh. Balav avodi, and therefore musical instruments are a nice accompaniment. But that's not the Iker Shira, and therefore it's not an Avaida, and therefore it's not the Echa Shabbos. Aval Shil Shal She'eva, the shear of the Simchas Reish Shoeva Divrei Hakol Simchahi Beinadechas Shabbos. Everybody agrees that's not an avoida. That's only for extra simcha, like Tesis said before, simcha yisera, and therefore everybody agrees it's not Deichas Shabbos. Okay, that is Rabbi Yosef's opinion.
Yeah.
Shofar, we do not blow on Shabbos for a different reason, though.
Why?
Because that is the same reason why we don't take lulav, because we're concerned someone's going to do haitzah. That's an issue. But back in the day, they did blow shofar, when there was a bezdin. The original takana of Rebbe Chaim Zakkai was that in a place where there was a bezdin, they would blow in bezdin. And I'm not mistaken, at some point, you know, the big... in Yerushalayim, there's the Hechel Shlomo. You're next to the Great Synagogue. Next to the Great Synagogue is the office of the Chief Rabbinate. In Yerushalayim, across from the plaza, is the office of the Chief Rabbinate. There's a big domed roof. And they built it for the Sanhedrin, because they were trying to bring back Smicha, and they wanted to have a Sanhedrin. And there was a point that the Briscoe put a ban on the building. It was a heated issue. But if I'm not mistaken, they used to blow shofar there on Shabbos. When for Shabbos Rosh Hashanah. And the real firmers, they couldn't go in, but they'd listen outside. I heard that this must have been the beginning of the state, the 50s, maybe, I think. This is a story I heard. I never verified it. This is something I heard. Okay, that's about the shofar. But here we have machlekes. This is a big machlekes. Is Shira. Again, the shir is obviously the words that were said. The question is the musical accompaniment an ikar, is an essential part of the shira, or is it secondary? It's not an ikar, it's only an accompaniment. It's not essential. That's a big machlekes. Is the ikar shira bekli, with the musical instruments, or is ikar shira bepeh, and not the musical instruments? That's the Gemara wants to say that's the machlekes here between Rabbi Yosi. And Rabbi Yosi, let's see a little bit. Where do I get that? This is what they're arguing about. So let's look at this. The Tanya, you learned in a brace. Kli sharis sha'asan shalitz. Kli sharis is a utensil. It was something that was used in the Beis Hamikdash. Now, they were all made out of metal, gold or silver or copper. Okay, shasan shalitz. What if I made it out of wood? Rabbi Paisel, Rabbi Yehuda Machshir. Okay, so if machlekes, if you have a kli sharis that was made out of wood, if that's kosher or pasul.
What is it?
A kli sharis is the shovels, any of the items used in the Beis Hamikdash are kli sharis, service utensils. Okay, can they be made out of wood? And so if you just think about, Parshas Truma, all of the utensils were made out of metal. But the urn had some wood in it, right? But it was plated with gold. All the other utensils were made out of metal. So what was made? Was there anything made out of wood? Yeah, it was made out of wood? The flute. The chalil. Chalil is not made out of metal, it's made out of wood. The woods, aren't they called that? What are they called? There's brass instruments, and then there are the woods. I think, I'm making that up. I don't know. But the flute was made of wood, and they actually tried to, the Gemara says that they wanted to coat it with gold, but it didn't sound right. When they took off the coating, it sounded correct. So therefore, it was made out of wood. Okay, so let's think about this for a second. If musical instruments are considered an essential part of Shira, and therefore they are part of the Avoida, that means they are considered klisharis, because they're used in Avaida. And I have one that was for sure wood. Well, if that could be wood, then anything could be wood. Right? But if playing instruments is not an essential part of Shira, and therefore it's not considered Avaida, then these instruments are not considered klisharis. And therefore, there are no klisharis that are made out of wood, and therefore using wood would be a problem. So that's what Mar says. Maybe that's the machlokes between Rabbi Yosi, Bar Yehuda, and Rebbe, and whether you can have other kli sharis made out of wood. Says the Gemara, "My love, Bakimifli, man de machshir saver ikar shir bekli." The one who says it's okay because he holds that the ikar essential shira is done with a kli, and therefore it's considered an avoida, and therefore it's considered a kli sharis. the alfinan me abuva de Moshe. And therefore, we learn out from the flute of abuva is a, I think the Aramaic way of saying Khalil. It means the flute of Moshe. I don't think it means Rashi doesn't. It wasn't Moshe Rabbeinu. I don't know if Moshe Rabbeinu played the flute, but it was the Moshe. It was the flute that was around in Moshe's days. I think that's what Rashi said somewhere here. Uman the pasul, the one who says it's invalid, suffered ikashir bepeh, and therefore v'lo yalpinu me'abuva the Moshe. Therefore, you can't learn out from the fact that even though there was a flute around the Moshe Rabbeinu's days, you can't learn to other klisharis because this thing is not considered a klisharis. Okay, that's what I wanted to say. That would be the machlekes to the base of Rabbi Yehuda and Rebbe. Kishmak machlekes whether the whether shira the ikar shira is bepeh or ikar shira is bekli. Okay. Now the Gemara says, well, that's not so muchach this machlekes. To say that the machlekes between Rebbe and Rabbi Yehuda and Rebbe Yehuda has to be dependent on this is not so stark. Light, the Gemara says, the kuli alma, it's possible that everybody holds ikar shira is bekli. Everybody agrees that kli that is an essential component to shira, but here there's a different issue. There's a machlekes if you have something which in which there was no other way to do it. So can that become a something I can learn out from? Right. So here the chalil, there was no other way to make it. I couldn't make a metal one. So does that mean now I can learn out to everywhere else that it could be? It doesn't have to be metal. Or I say, listen, it needs to be metal, but in a case where you can't do metal, so you can't do metal. Right? That's the machlek. That's called done in efshir mishi'i efshir. Can you learn something which is possible to do another way from something which is not possible to do another way? Says the Gemara. Machlek is whether you can learn out something which is possible to do a different way from something which is not possible to do a different way. Man the machshir. The one that says that all klisharis can be made out of wood, which means I can learn out from the flute, sever done in efshir mishi efshir. He goes, you're allowed to learn possible from impossible. Man the possible one says you can't. I mean, it would be invalid to have a klisharis made out of wood, sever done in efshir mishi efshir. Okay, that's our second possibility for the machlekes. Now, Mamor says a third possibility. The ibay is same as the kuli alma the ikar shir bepeh. You can go the other way. Really, everybody can hold that you need the efshir bepeh. And the ain done in efshir mishi efshir, and you're not allowed to learn out possible from impossible. If that's the case, so what's the machlokes? Here, the machlokes is a very general machlokes in how you dash in the Torah. Right, and this we'll spend a few minutes on. You've come across the concept of klal uprat uklal or ribui miut miut. Riboy miut riboy. What? In Rabbi Shmuel, I said it. Excellent. So that's one of the yugim amidas of Torah Drushas. The one way you kadash in the Torah is when the Torah writes a general rule and then it tells you something specific and then tells you the general rule again. So how do I view that? Okay. So the example here of by the menorah, the Gemara says make a menorah. If it says make a menorah, so I can make it out of anything. Then it says zav, tells you something specific, and then it tells you again. It says, I don't remember, something about making the menorah. Where is it? Yeah, Zav Tar is Prat. Everybody says it here. And then it says Tasa Hamaneri, Shoyin Kamer, Miksha Tasa Hamaneri. Thank you. So that's the pasuk. So the rule's like this. If it goes like this, if you darshin klal prat uklal, so Torah says a klal, and then it says a prat, that means it has to be only that way. And then it's meaning it's klal, if it's just a klal prat, you go with the prat. But that, and then when it says a klal again, it's coming to tell you, okay, so it doesn't mean only the prat, but it has to be something that's similar to the prat. So if I'm learning all the klisheres out of menorah, so the Torah says you have to make a menorah, I would say anything, you can make it out of any material. Then it says gold. Oh, so I guess it has to be gold. And then it says, again, you should make the menorah, klal. Okay, it doesn't have to be gold, but it has to be something similar to gold, which would mean metal, not wood. Okay? The other way to dash in the Torah is the Torah saying a ribui. Ribui means everything is included. Then it says a miut. The miut would mean anything that is, okay, so it's not everything, it's things that are similar to things that are similar to the miut. And then it gives you a klal again, so we're back to being everything with one exclusion. Okay, that's the two ways to learn the Torah. So let's read it inside. It says the Gemara, So it goes like this. It says you should make a menorah klal. That means you can make it out of anything. Zavtar, pure silver, prat. That's an exclusion. It means it can only be made out of zavtar. And then it says miksha tasa menorah. It says you should make it out of a solid piece, chazer v'kol. It gave you a generalization again. So the rule is klal upratu klal. I'atadan, you only judge a ke'ina prat. It has to be similar to the prat. Maha prat mefura shlamatachas. Just like the prat is metal. So everything else has to be metal as well. And you can only use metal. Rabbi Yosef, Rabbi Yehuda, he darshins it differently. He says, that's an inclusive statement. Zav tar mi eight. It's being reminded, it's saying it's not everything that's in the klal. It has to be something that's similar to the miut. Then if it says again, mikshatasa menaira, that's chazer v'riba. Then it includes it again. So riba umir v'riba riba kol. You include everything. My rabbi, rabbi akol mili. My mi. What are you excluding? So you can exclude the thing that's like the least sheiches, and that is mi shulcheres, pottery or clay. So according to him, you can make a kli sheres out of anything except for cheres, pottery. And according to rabbi, you can make it. It has to be something which is similar to gold, which means metal. As opposed, and therefore it would exclude wood as well. All right, tomorrow Mishnah will continue with this machlekes of ikashir bepeh or ikashir bekli.